Shalom Aleichem. Learning a little bit more from the wonderful Likutei Halachot by Rabbi Nachman, Rabbi Natan of Breslov, student of Rabbi Nachman of Breslov. And talking about people that are going through crazy challenges of low self-esteem and self-criticism. And saying and talking about this topic that I mentioned last week, that a person can learn on himself that the challenges and difficulties that he's going through are not a sign for a weakness or default of his spirit, of his soul. Just the opposite of that, that if a person has a great evil inclination, yetzer hara, it means that for sure his spirit is a very precious and holy spirit in its root. And therefore, the villains and the evil inclination are overpowering him. Because as much as the spirit is great and precious and high, the evil inclination is trying to overpower it more and more and more. And like the Torah sages said, that a person that is greater than his friend in certain quality, his yetzer hara, his evil inclination is greater as well. And like that, the sages said that the evil inclination allows all the people, regular men, people, like just to be, and he's not fighting with them, just with the special souls that are more precious, like the more important ones, the more precious ones, and more and more and more. And that's the next part that I wanted to translate, to read to you today. That it's not the way of real true humility, being really humble, to hold himself as real complete evil, God forbid, to lower and minimize the quality of his Holy Spirit. Just a person should know and to believe that his spirit in its root is great and precious and very, very high. Thousands and tens of thousands of worlds depends on it with no amount. And like that Rabbi Nachman of Breslov said, that if they would... It's of course like an example, like a tale, that if they would flip the person, they would see that inside of him there is a whole back end that made out of veins and strings, that the person is connected from within to thousands and thousands and tens of thousands of worlds that depends on him. And as well, it's written in other many, many books on the quality of the spirit of the man, that is in the aspect of the shape of God, a godly portion. And even the soul of the lowest one of them all is also very, very high. And even more so, the great precious souls of the Torah learners, that they are, and especially Torah learners. We're talking about people that desires to learn Torah, that are hoping to learn Torah. Especially those with great mind, with great desires to learn the wisdom and the truth. Because as much as the mind of the person is desiring higher goals, it's a simple sign that his soul is higher and higher. And like the Rabbi Nachman of Breslov wrote, that the soul is the mind. So if you see that you have a great mind, so your soul is great as well. And like that it's written, V'nishmat shaddai tevinim, that power of wisdom is power of the soul. And therefore the person that has mind sees, when he sees that the evil inclination is overpowering him more and more, he should know that for sure he has a great, very powerful and highly spirit. And he should overpower the difficulties and challenges and to have mercy on himself, not to lose those treasures and precious wonders that are treasured in his, that depends and treasured in his spirit, that no eye ever saw before. And he should strengthen himself in any kind of power to save his spirit from falling down to sadness and depression, and to save it from those villains that trying to overpower it and break it down and to lower him. And the main way is by many individual prayers and simple requests, talking to Hashem from your heart in the aspect of Vayigbali bo bedarkei Hashem, that the heart of the person is rising and growing in the paths of Hashem, that you should hold yourself as important and precious, that you should rise your heart and your mind in the ways of Hashem, and to tell yourself that it's not the right way for me to do this kind of things, to act like an animal, God forbid, to act in low ways. Just my spirit that is so precious and highly, a spirit of the people of Israel that are all children of kings, it's worthy for me to act in royalty and in holy ways of kingship. Like that, it's proper for the spirits of Israel that are being called children, you are to Hashem, your God. And that is the aspect of what it is written in the Torah on our sages that said, I am a small creation in the sea. And they said that the goodness of the spirit of the people of Israel remembers their own quality, that they are those ones who came to the mind of Hashem first, and he consulted with them and asked them their opinion before creating his world. And now, God forbid, are we allowed to let that spirit be so down and broken in filthy places? God forbid. And by that, by reminding ourselves of our quality and our greatness, a person can rise back to his level. And this is something that most people mistake to think, and they assume that their spirit is not so holy in its root. And then it's hard for them to come back to Hashem and to be a righteous person or a real kosher one, like the rest of the real, true, kosher and righteous people. Why? Like that, many people that are responding when they hear stories on true righteous people, they start thinking about he's explaining, Rabbi Natan is explaining here that it's hard for people to believe in themselves, and like that it happens to many people that they do not believe in themselves. And when they hear a story of righteous people, in the beginning, they start to wake up with positive thoughts, to think about ways how to also start coming closer and closer to Hashem and to be close to Him. But after a while, they're immediately telling themselves, who am I to compare myself to that righteous man? Because he was a great holy soul from his youth. And people got used to say those things, that the righteousness and holiness of the righteous people and the kosher people is from the side of their holy soul that they have, that they received it in their birth. But the truth is not like that. And like the Rabbi Nachman of Breslov said, that it's not so. And that the main holiness of the person depends in his effort and in his will. And that is the main lacking of the world, that they're saying that people that are holy because they were born holy, is a mistake. And because of that, those people are not waking up and not overpowering their evil inclination to compare themselves to the righteous ones and to be righteous on their own. But the real truth is that is not the right way. And the main righteousness of the righteous one and the kosher one is only by him standing against the Yetzer Hara and evil inclination and fighting back and strengthening himself over and over to fight and to bother and to put a lot of effort serving Hashem, to put so much effort, days and years, and did not let himself fall in no way in the world, and increased his prayers to thousands on times of hitbodedut, of individual prayer, and to beg to Hashem and to pray until the person will reach the level that he can reach, everyone according to his value and to his ability. Praiseworthy are those who will not give up. And any person can be like those true righteous ones, because the free choice is in the hand of everyone, and the crown of a good name is offered. And everyone who wants to gain it can gain it. Like that it's written, the crown of Kehuna was given to Aharon, the crown of kingship was given to King David, and the crown of good name is offered, and everyone who wants to gain it can gain it if he wants. And the real matter is that when people are mistaking themselves to think and to assume that their spirit is not precious and holy, and because of that they're not overpowering and getting stronger to do what the real true righteous ones did, all that is coming from a place that is called the halls of changes, heichaleat murot, the places of transactions, transformations. that from that place, confusions are coming to the world. Like the king, the son of the king, like the prince that was switched and with the son of the slave, and he, like, so now the prince was considered a slave, and the slave was considered a prince. And he himself was, even though that he heard some rumors that he was the real prince, he was doubting himself if he was the real prince, or maybe he was the son of the slave, God forbid. This is a story based on the story of Rabbi Nachman of Breslov. But all the time he had those thoughts of tshuva. He was always thinking, what is the right way and what is the real truth? And maybe he is and maybe he's not. And always thinking and considering and hoping. And he was doubting himself if he was the real prince or not. And any person is like that, that he feels that he's far from Hashem Yitbarach, and especially because that the darkness is so heavy and thick in the end of the exile that is so bitter. And those are hours before the time of Mashiach coming. And the evil inclination is overpowering in those times in great ways. And the evil inclination is fighting, especially on the souls of Israel, like we can see that. That so many people are falling to despair, like their spirit is not capable of dealing with Avodat Hashem and serving Hashem at all. And that is only the temptation of the negative thoughts that the evil inclination is putting in the minds of the people, to weaken their thoughts and to put in his heart weakness and to think that he is small and to think that he belongs to the other side and to the Sitra Achra. But all of that is coming from that place of transformations and changes, from the aspect of that change of the prince with the son of the slave, that he fell to such place that he himself did not know, couldn't be sure if he was the real prince or not. But the truth is that a person must know and believe that the spirit of each and every one of the people of Israel is precious and highly and holy, and everyone are children of kings and can achieve high, high levels and holy levels like the rest of the righteous and kosher ones. Because on all the true righteous kosher people, difficulties went through and horrible thoughts and weaknesses that we cannot imagine. But they were wise and strong not to let those foreign thoughts make them mistake, and they overpowered against them till they reached and achieved what they achieved. And if you say to yourself, why is he talking only about the souls of Israel? What about us? What with all the rest of the world? So I'm telling you, wake up and smell the roses, because the tribe of Yehuda is around 15 million people today. Those are the known Jewish people. But there are another 10 lost and forgotten tribes that are out there. There were 12 tribes, and now there are 12, there are one or two tribes that are known as the people of Israel. Those are the Jewish people. And the other 10 tribes are under a certain cloud of forgetfulness. And they're not sure if they are Israelis or not. And they for sure are not holding the tradition of the Israeli people that follow the rules of the Torah and our sages, that their wisdom was given especially to the people of the Jewish tribe and the tribes of Israel that were lost 1,000 years before the sages came. Because of that reason and other reasons, were not able to keep the tradition in strength as the Jewish people are today. And therefore, there are many contradictions and many thoughts and many confusions, but there are 10 lost tribes, that every one of those tribes was not chased for his Judaism and was not chased for his, for the fact that they were Israeli souls as much as the Jewish people. And they blend and mixed with the rest of the nations in a certain way that they lost their religion. And because of that, they are not even remembering their greatness and their goodness. But the real truth is that they are as precious and as holy as the rest of the souls of Israel, and they're not in lower level than the Jewish people that are one tribe out of 12. And if you ask yourself, why am I saying 12 and then 1 and 12 and then 1 and 10 and 12 and 1, as if I don't know that 10 and 1 is 11 and I was talking about 12. So the reason is that there is another half of tribe of Binyamin that joined the tribe of Yehuda, and there are other people from different tribes of Israel that also joined the tribe of Yehuda. So it's actually almost two tribes that are included in the tribe of Yehuda. Those are the Jewish people that are the Jewish people that are known as Jews today. And the rest of the tribes are covering the world with great light. Wait for hundreds on hundreds of millions of people suddenly that all the darkness of their sadness and depression and low self-esteem will be removed by a prayer of Mashiach Tzidkenu, and they will find the root of their souls and will wake up and smell the roses and come back home, and the land of Israel will bloom and shine and rise again, and the temple of Hashem will be revealed. May it happen in our days. Amen.
You know me, my name is RDMC. With the Emuna Project, all the nations with me. Close your eyes, just breathe, see the truth. Don't chase the fake world, don't buy the fake news. Be yourself, your own true self. Don't let no one take our natural wealth. See the good, no fear, no despair. Cherish who that you are and share.
Source of power from an endless spring, light of courage in yourself.
They can kick you down to the ground. Hold yourself up till you are, put up your crown. King of the Creator, holy soul inside. Focus on the spiritual and you shall...